Okay, guys, so this is Ernie. Anyways, we literally are leaving the hospital right now. It's 5 o'clock. It's been a very long day, but it's been a very good day. Hopefully Ernie is gonna keep his happiness during rush hour.
I am very happy.
During rush hour.
I am very happy.
Anyways, the bilirubin went down slightly. It was, what was it at?
It was 4.8. It went to 4.5, but like the doctor, the doctor said, it's moving in the right direction.
And slow is fine.
Yeah.
So I was able to get treatment today. It's probably the first time. I've wanted chemo treatments before, but it's never been so, like, if you don't get this chemo treatment, like, we're out of options. So my oncologist came in with a huge smile on her face when she saw me. She was like, you look 100% better. Your color looks better. I've been feeling, I am weak. That's the one physical thing that's changed. Some of that has to do with, I just don't have an appetite. I can't eat very much. But that's okay, because I'm alive and I'm here. And this is, I'm just going to say, this is like the happiest I've been in such a long time, because I feel, I've always been hopeful during this process, but when the clinical trial failed and my liver percentage functioning went from 75% to 25%, and they started talking to me real serious about hospice, and I wasn't ready for all that. So anyways, like I promised you guys, we will most likely every week at least do a video after the infusion to keep you guys like up to date on the medical detail part. But emotionally, I just literally, and I mean this from the deepest depths of my soul and my heart, thank you for every single prayer, thought,
intention,
good vibe, cyber hug you've sent me, real hugs. I've had Melissa Livingston, who was one of my best friends, flying for a surprise visit. I had Angelica, an old friend from MCI, flying for a surprise visit. I have another surprise visitor coming on Saturday, who you'll find out who that is when she gets here.
And it's not so much of a surprise for us, because we know who it is.
We know who it is, but it'll be a surprise to you guys. Ernie's mom is coming on Friday. We're getting visitors. The flowers you guys have sent, the care packages. I'm so sorry I haven't had energy to like record those thank yous, but we are getting them. They are brightening our days.
We're speechless too with the amount of support that from my job. All the pay time off being donated so I could spend time with Christina and still get a paycheck.
And help take care of me physically.
Yeah, yeah.
Because we are going to get nurses to come in. We did sign up for palliative care, which is different than hospice. So there'll be some nurses coming in probably in the next week or two for just a few hours a day so that Alyssa can focus on taking care of Ava. And the nurses can help me rest and teach me things just to help me get around better as I get better. So just thank you guys so much. I really can't think of, thank you's not enough. I don't know what the word is, Ernie. There must be a bigger word.
Well, that's the only words we know. Thank you. We appreciate it. It's all helping. And I am definitely, I put out that special prayer request last night for the bilirubin counts to be going down, and they did. And I believe in no small part to all your intentions and prayers and pleading.
And if you're in this situation, like you're, either you have primary liver cancer or cancer that's metastasized to your liver or something, two things that really helped, and it seems so minor, but because I'm on such a low dose chemo, I'm finally able to drink water. and drinking. I'm trying to work up to 4 liters a day. But I'm at 2.5, but just getting to that 2.5 has helped flush the bile out of my system. And also I've been trying to sit in the sun for at least a half hour a day, which you also have to balance with chemo. But my oncologist was okay with that. And I think it's helped. So if you're going through something like this, those are the two very simple things that I have done, is drinking more fluids to assist the liver. But also I think, oh, my cousin came over and brought me a beautiful Greek icon.
St. Catherine of Alexandria, Greek Orthodox saint.
And she's, a lot of healings have been attributed to her, and we've received so much love, and our spirits are renewed, everything is renewed. We needed it. We needed you guys, and thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
And thank you.
And also every night in our prayers, we don't just beg for our own intentions. Every single person who is on Team Christina, and even those who are not, who are fighting this battle with cancer, we pray for their healing. We pray for
your needs too.
For your needs too. And so always feel free to put a prayer request on our pages. I have over 225 notifications on Facebook, so I think you guys understand I won't be able to respond to all those, but I'm reading them and they are uplifting my spirits. I've been so fatigued, just reading can make me fall asleep like within 5 minutes. So it's a little hard, but Ernie, oh, our Canadian angels. Tim and Sherry sent us an amazing care package with these amazing, like, organic...
We have quite a few Canadian angels, however, actually.
Yes. The Edge, the Brat. But I want to talk about the organic pickled...
Oh, right, the preserves and the pickles they sent us.
She sent me a beautiful pearl necklace. Alyssa loved the makeup and the Canadian socks I went crazy for, so... Thank you for that. Anyways, I am in such good spirits. You know when you're like so happy and so relieved and like a huge monkey's been lifted off your back? That's how I feel right now.
Oh my gosh, you guys, last night there was so much anxiety and stress. She was a mess.
I just, you know, I was crying. I was a mess. But because of fear of the unknown, so I told my oncologist today... I'm part of a stage 4 triple negative group. It's a closed group only for women who are stage 4 triple negative. But I, you know, posted them this morning. You know, last week they said to me, like, well, we thought you were prepared to die. I am prepared to die. I understand. I've accepted what death is. It's part of life. But doesn't mean I want to die now, just because I've prepared myself spiritually and emotionally. I told my oncologist today I will fight to stay alive all the way until the end, however long that is. And I'm not going to let it get gruesome or like crazy or anything to where I can't talk or anything, but I'm going to fight. And I'm gonna do everything I can to heal. And for those of you who are wondering, there are some alternative things we're doing that my oncologist has approved. If those things end up helping, of course I will share them with you guys. But mostly this is just a good news video. And thank you guys, and
My love, you are quite very coherent considering they just gave you some pain meds to the IV.
I've been real resistant to pain meds because I knew there was going to come a point where I needed them, which is now. But I've been taking them every day and it's helped quite a bit. So I think I just have a bit more tolerance. But anyways, our light's going to run out soon. But because we're going to go in the garage. But Ernie, do you have anything?
I just want to... I can't say how much all the support and love we've been shown on Facebook and YouTube and, you know, through friends and family and people we've never met from around the world, literally from around the globe, from the Middle East to Australia to Europe to Canada to South America, Brazil, all over the U.S.
All over the place.
You know, Asia, you know, you name it. We've gotten love and support from there, and believe me, it may seem like nothing, a little note of encouragement,
oh,
you know, a prayer,
but
it means the world to us, and it keeps us, you know, it makes us feel a lot better knowing that we're not alone.
Yes,
so thank you.
If you're friends or have a close family member who's going through any type of illness, chronic or not, you know, just showing up for them. My best friend Natasha's been coming over like 3 times a week, and I told her just showing up and having even an hour-long conversation has been so uplifting. So anyways, our light's gonna run out and I don't want to ruin this video, so love you. I'm gonna post this tonight, and let's just keep praying for the good fight. Okay,
thank you all.
Bye.
Talk to you soon.